How do I convert a GPT disk to MBR? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got just recently. While following your instructions in your Macrium Reflect course lesson creating rescue media, I ran into an issue when trying to create the rescue media on a USB stick. When I reached the step to build the emergency disk, I received the message, removable USB flash drive, unsupported disk, and GPT format not supported. MBR and GPT are two different, well, what Microsoft calls partition styles for hard disks. Essentially, they're the information, or that's the table that includes the information about where the partitions actually live on the disk. So before you can even create partitions, you need to have initialized the disk with either MBR or GPT. For the record, MBR stands for Master Boot Record. It's fairly old, and it has a limitation on how large the drives can be that it can support. GPT, GUID Partition Table, or where GUID is G-U-I-D, which stands for Globally Unique Identifier, is a more modern and these days often a default partition style that can handle disks of much, much larger size. So it's not uncommon to run into a situation where your disk, however you created it, happens to be GPT. How to convert it to MBR? Well, we've got a couple of approaches. I want to show you what those are. So we're here in Windows 11. I'm going to fire up Windows Disk Manager, and you'll see that right away it's complaining about one of the disks I have. This disk has not yet been initialized. In other words, there is no partition table on this disk. It's uncommon to run into this, but I wanted to include it because it does show you exactly what initializing a disk really means. And in fact, you have a choice. You can say Master Boot Record or GUID Partition Table. Now, in this case, I'm going to initialize it to be GUID Partition Table, GPT, because that's more commonly what you'll find. And I'm actually going to go ahead and throw a quick partition on there, quick volume on there. So this would be a more common scenario where you have a disk. If you take a look at its properties over on the left-hand side, right-clicking and clicking on properties, you'll see that under volumes, it lists this as a GUID Partition Table. So this is more common. You'll have a disk, it has one or more partitions on it, and it is a GPT partition style. So one approach to getting rid of it, doesn't always work, but one approach to converting it to MBR is to remove all of the partitions on this disk. Now, to be clear, when we remove the partitions or we do this conversion, you are deleting all of the data on this disk. So make sure there is nothing on this disk that you want to keep. I'm going to right-click on it, delete the volume to remove the partition. Now I'm going to right-click on this disk again on the left-hand side, and there is now a convert to MBR disk, which is exactly what we wanted to have happen. I'm not going to do it here because the next approach that I want to show you is going to be more common. The issue is that I have seen scenarios where this option is not available in Disk Manager. So if it is, hit this, convert to MBR disk, and then in the case of a tool like Macrium Reflect where you're creating your emergency disk, it'll create a partition for you. If you're about to use this disk and if you needed to convert it to MBR for some other reason, your next step would be to create a new logical volume on this disk so you could actually use it. You would be creating a partition. But I'm going to leave it here as a GPT disk with no partitions on it. A different approach to doing this that works if the convert to MBR option is not available in Disk Management is to use the command line. So we're going to right-click on the start menu and click on the admin version of whatever you find here, be it terminal, command prompt, PowerShell, etc. This does need to be done in the admin version of those tools. The tool we're going to use is diskpart. The very first thing we're going to do is list disk. This will list the disks that diskpart is aware of. Now, at this point, what we want to do is we want to choose the correct disk, either disk 0 or disk 1. Make sure you choose the correct disk. I say that because this operation, again, will empty the disk. It'll erase everything that's on the disk. Now, in this case, it's pretty obvious. I have one of the disks here is 127 gigabytes in size with 126 gigabytes free. That tells me that that's the disk we were just playing with. The other disk, disk zero, clearly has a bunch of stuff on it. Since I just deleted the partitions on this disk, it makes sense that there is nothing in use and that it is pretty close to being completely free. That's the disk we're going to use. We'll select disk one. We'll clean the disk. And now we will convert MBR. Disk successfully converted. This part then is done. If we now go back to disk management and we take a look at the properties for this disk, you'll see that it is listed as a master boot record. And if we wanted to, since the option was available, since it has no partitions on it yet, we actually could have converted it back to a GPT disk at this point. But if you want it to be an MBR disk, like I said, at this point, then you would create yourself a new simple volume, give it a name if you want. NTFS is a fine file system. Otherwise, you might consider using something like XFAT. Hit next. And now, if all of a sudden, we have a new volume on it. In this case, you'll see that if you right-click on it again, the convert to either GPT disk or MBR disk isn't even available because there are partitions. If that's the case, that means you need to remove the partitions in order to perform the conversion. This option may not even be present, in which case you'll need to use the command line version that I just showed you. But hopefully that gets you what you're looking for. This is a way to take a disk and convert it from GPT partition style to MBR, master boot record partition style. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/182116. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.